Why Shane McMahon is the SmackDown hacker. So, before I get into any reasons, any of my reasons as to why I believe he's the SmackDown hacker, first and foremost, I've got to say this. Please, 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 WWE, do not do this. Please. We as fans don't need more Shane McMahon. We had enough of Shane in 2018 and 2019 especially. We don't need more of him. Alright, but that said, there are some pretty damn, almost irrefutable reasons that I've come up with as to why Shane McMahon is the SmackDown hacker. Now, before I get into any of these reasons, I must say, most of the people, or the people I've seen talk about the SmackDown hacker and assume who it will be, obviously, I've seen Mustafa Ali. That one's been thrown around a lot. That is the logical, like, no-brainer option. I've seen CM Punk, which is laughable. If you think Phil Brooks is a SmackDown hacker, there's something wrong with you. Let's see, who else? Xavier Woods. I've seen Xavier Woods potentially being a SmackDown hacker. I've seen, there's some different women I've seen who could be the SmackDown hacker. I've seen a bunch of different ideas. But in this video, I'll be giving you my definitive reasons why Shane McMahon is a SmackDown hacker. So without further ado, let's get into this. Reason one. This is the WWE, and they have a history of nepotism overriding logic. Just look for a prime example, Crown Jewel 2018, and the WWE, quote-unquote, World Cup, unquote. The WWE World Cup, on paper, this is 2018, so cast your mind back around a year and three quarters or so to October 2018. Who were the, quote-unquote, best in the world as far as wrestlers at that time? Seth Rollins? Dolph Ziggler, maybe? Those kind of guys? Yeah, you're more so like IC title, your mid-card work rate wrestlers, those types. So, you make sure to give the WWE World Cup, the best in the world, gets given to Shane McMahon. Shane McMahon is the WWE best in the world World Cup winner. Okay, that instance right there proves to me that no matter what makes sense, what is logical, this at the end of the day is Vince McMahon's company, and if he feels like giving his son the best in the world and, this to accolade, they're going to do it. And it applies to this SmackDown hacker situation. Regardless of what the right decision is as far as who the SmackDown hacker is, so Mustafa Ali, this is Vince McMahon, and he could so easily just say, no, we want Shane, we want Shane to be the SmackDown hacker. So that's reason one. Reason two. Shane McMahon hasn't been on SmackDown since the premiere episode on Fox back in October 2019, when he lost the ladder match to Kevin Owens. Accordingly, and this is what I was thinking, the truth will be heard catchphrase makes complete sense for if it was Shane McMahon, because having the former heel authority figure who's been intently watching from the sidelines this whole time, making a statement and making sure that the truth is heard, it just makes sense. Shane has no associations or links to any wrestlers. He's not like a Xavier Woods or a Mustafa Ali who's an active member of the roster. Shane McMahon, his role was that he was the authority figure overseeing things. It would make sense if he's been cast away and banished, he'd still be intently focused on everything that's happening. So as a result, he has stuff to expose the truth for, alright? And he'd have no bias as far as divisions. If Shane McMahon was the hacker revealing the truth, he'd talk about the SmackDown women's division, the SmackDown tag team division, or the Otis-Mandy storyline, he'd have no care and no attachment, which I think makes sense. So that's reason two. Reason three, I've kind of mentioned this before, but reason three, even if it was supposed to be or is supposed to be Mustafa Ali, this is WWE. Vince McMahon likely changes his mind momentarily and gives up on Ali altogether, opting to go with his own son out of nepotism. Once again, nepotism, Vince McMahon changing his mind, going with his son instead of Ali. This is all stuff that WWE more than would do. So, reason four, SmackDown has been getting some momentum lately. The last few shows have been actually good, and I'll be the first person to say that. Now, this past week, as far as the Jeff Hardy one where he got a DUI live on SmackDown with Elias being hit by the drive-by or whatnot, and they did that whole angle, that show was alright to good. It's a bit subjective. Maybe you hated it, but for the most part, you're saying alright to good. And then the SmackDown the week before with Charlotte versus Bayley, with the two IC title tournament matches, with the mixed tag team match, that show was almost universally acclaimed as good. So SmackDown's been gaining some momentum, and as a result, because this is WWE, what better way of ruining that momentum than revealing Shane McMahon as the SmackDown hacker? It'd just be so WWE, wouldn't it? So that's reason four. Reason five, we haven't had a McMahon as a marquee component of a WWE program since that aforementioned October 2019 Shane McMahon SmackDown on Fox premiere. We haven't seen a McMahon as a main component on programming. We haven't. We've seen Vince McMahon appear in the Triple H 25th anniversary ceremony, but that was just a one-off. And what else? We haven't seen Stephanie McMahon. We've seen Triple H, that aforementioned, like, one time, and then on NXT Triple H has been on there a couple of times. He was on SmackDown doing commentary, but not as far as, like, an authority figure. Triple H is just kind of there. So obviously, we haven't seen Shane. Vince has had one appearance. Stephanie hasn't been there. We haven't seen a McMahon as a marquee component of WWE programming since. So surely that's going to change sometime soon, don't you think? Now, that's reason five. Reason six, the sixth and final reason I have why Shane McMahon is the SmackDown hacker, because this, here's my reason, this would be so stereotypical WWE, it's not funny. If you watch the shows week in, week out, and see all the crap they do on a weekly basis, you can easily picture this, can't you? This is so WWE. Making Shane McMahon the SmackDown hacker instead of Mustafa Ali, like not showing Mustafa Ali on television for literally 5 months, or 6 months now, 7 months perhaps, and having none of that be relevant, but having Shane McMahon as the SmackDown hacker. You can picture it, can't you? I know you can. So that's the video. If you enjoyed, be sure to like, comment, and sub. Once again, just to reiterate this, if Shane McMahon is a SmackDown hacker, I would be nauseated. I'd just laugh my head off, because it, based off the reasons I made in this video, these six reasons, it would not surprise me one little bit. So that's been the video. Hopefully you've enjoyed. If you have, be sure to like, comment, and sub. If you enjoyed this, you're probably going to enjoy my other content. Hopefully this does well, and hopefully you enjoyed it. So like, comment, sub. See ya.